Well, hello everyone, I'm Jenny from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Potion Pause. And I realized that you can actually save, unlike Garden Pause. In Garden Pause you have to sleep overnight to save, and in this one you can actually save right here, which is awesome. You don't have to go back to your bed, at least for now. I don't know if they're going to change it, but it also seems to auto-save pretty frequently, so it's like every 5 minutes or something, based on the number of saves that were in my folder afterwards, because just like with Garden Pause, it actually saves the last like 10 saves or so, which is always handy if you have to roll back a little bit, right? I also realized, because I was running around, as you can see, collecting a whole bunch of stuff afterwards, both in the earth zone here, and I've kind of been running around out here, so I have a lot of grass and stuff now, and also get flies in the earth zone, so that's a nice little detail to remember. But I realized you can actually break the pumpkin when you throw it. It's just sometimes it doesn't quite break into pieces, but if you try and either throw it or just drop it on the ground, then it will eventually break and you get pumpkin slices from it. So we're gonna have to see what we can do with those, but let's see. The water stone is currently under development, but we welcome you to explore this drop of heaven. So when I came out from there, there was a note, but now it's locked. Which I kind of would assume it would be. I wouldn't really assume that you could go in there just yet. Okay, well, let's head back here. I know I keep just stealing everything here. Well, we need to make a grow plant potion and we need to make some more money, right? We have a little bit of a floating tree here. Let's grab a little screenshot of that, and then I think we're gonna head back home and try and make some more potions. We did learn like a pumpkin one, didn't we? Which of course we're gonna have to try and make so we can actually see it properly in our potion book, but we'll see. Let's head back up here. And here we go, let's grab one of these. Okay, so I guess that is the only one I have right now. I don't know what about storage, so I guess now we have to unlock storage somehow. In the previous version, there was actually a chest right here that you could use to store stuff in, but that does not seem to be accessible at the moment. Okay, well, let's go in here. And let's take a little look in our potion book. Ooh, it's nice. It remembers the potions now. Yeah. Okay, so we can make these. Then we have this one, this one. Ooh, it looks like a firefly potion, and we do need fireflies for it. Not sure what this one does. Don't know what that does either, but we do have everything you need for it, and this must be the pumpkin one. Okay, so we need 10 pumpkin slices, so we're gonna have to go back to the earth zone and get some more of those, but I have been standing around collecting some blue goo and some water from the pool, so we have enough that we can make this one. So let's see what that one does, right? Oh, no. Oh boy, this happens a lot, that you end up pressing the wrong one. Ooh, we got a bubble potion. Ooh, lovely. It looks like maybe we can get bubbled. I don't know if we can. Can I make another one? No, we don't have enough for it. We need more water and more bottles, of course. Okay. Well, let's just try and go out and then we're gonna try it and see. Let's just try to... yeah, let's try and drink it. Oh, look at that! Look at us! okay, I am not quite sure what that would... how this would work. Okay, it doesn't seem to do anything when you're jumping. I was kind of wondering if it would make you float down slowly or something. That's not the case. Later we're gonna try and throw it and see if that does something. Maybe you can bubble a monster or something in the dungeon. Oh my dear. Okay, well, let's try and make something else, because we can make a lot of tree breaking potions and we can get a whole bunch of wood. We can make one more of these. Let's do that. Let's make one of these. All right. I don't have any. Yep. Okay, we need more potion bottles. There we go. Now we have 10. That should be something for now. So let's see. What was I trying to make? I was trying to make one of these. So let's do that. Select. And let's make ourselves a potion. Okay, so we got the confetti one. We did try out both of them, didn't we? Both eating and or both drinking and throwing it. Then we have this one. We can make more of that, but for right now, let's keep it because there might be another use for the caterpillar, and I'm not sure what this is used for. Oh, the prices are actually right there. I hadn't even noticed. Look at that. So we get 117 for this. Got 182 if we sell that one. This one actually gives us 702, so it might be worth it to hang around over by the little pool and get some water and goof just for that, right? And then we have the growth plant. Well, we do need one for the Adventurer's Guild quest, so let's select, and then we're gonna make that. Nice. So now we have one for that quest there. Let's see, what do we need for you? 10 of these and 5 of these, that gives us 150. Okay, well, these are kind of rarer. Right? Yeah, lavender, then we have to go into the Earth Zone. It does give us a little bit more money, but it's so easy to get these right here in the zone we are in right now. And then, of course, getting these. So I think we're just gonna make some more of these, and then we also need to test it out because we haven't actually tested it yet, have we? Because we had to hand in the one we made, and I sold the other ones. Let's just try and make some of these. Here we go. Yep, let's make one more. There we go, now we can't make any more of those, and then I think for the rest of it, we're just gonna make these. Get some tree breaking potions. And yeah, of course, eventually we're gonna be breaking a whole lot of wood, but we're just gonna have to figure out how that works. But yeah, so far it's still kind of buggy, but I'm recording this right after the last episode, so there hasn't been any bug fixes or anything, of course, since the previous episode. But I'm sure they're gonna get this fixed and then we can clean up the house properly. But let's head down here. We're gonna see how long we're gonna be stuck with this bubble. Oh yes, here we go. And then we are gonna sell some stuff here. So let's divide you, then we're gonna take, well, not quite all of them. Let's first try it, and I don't know if the plant is gonna stick around. I think we can do something here. Let's just try it right here, right? Oh, look at that. Oh, pick up. Oh yeah, then we can harvest it again, but these kind of stick around the grass under it, but I think we're gonna be able to see those in another biome that we haven't been to yet. It might be the water biome or something. Okay, so now we have tried it, and then we do need, oh yes, so control click lets you take just one out of the stack, just like in Garden Post. So that is lovely. Aha, so let's go back down here. I just wanted to see if we could harvest them or we should leave them, so, but we could harvest them right away. Here we go. Let's put these in here. That gives us 600, right? It's not quite enough yet. Then we're gonna sell the U2, that's 182, and then I think we're just gonna sell all of these right now so that we get enough money. Almost. Yeah, we don't quite have enough for that quest yet, but if we go over here and we sell something, let's just sell some grass, that gives us 35. Uh-huh. And then we should have enough money for Birdie. Yeah, lovely, lovely, lovely. Let's go and hand in this quest first. And there we go. I hope we're gonna find a way to make some strides soon, because the more areas we get access to, the more different items or resources we're gonna have, right? So we're gonna be missing room And I don't really want to sell everything. Well, we can sell some of the grass and stuff that we have a lot of course. Here we go. Let's go over here. So, yep. Deliver one grow plant potion. Delivered Conrad bulk order. Awesome. So, let's see. There are no other quests in the board. Well, it doesn't really have like a new day in the same way. Well, I don't know. It's, you know, because it's so misty. So I don't know when there's a new day. Maybe if we sleep, we can get a new day. But you don't really... Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay, this might not be the place you want to walk around too much, as you can see. Yeah, we got toilet paper there. Okay, let's see. So we have leveled up to 60. Wow, we're gonna need to make a lot of grow plant potions. Ah, and this alternates, it looks like, because now I have a new one down here. I don't feel like we had that last time. We had like an inventory one last time down here, but now we have Grasgon. Grasgons will start spawning in the Earth Zone, unlocks at level 4. So, maybe this randomizes a little bit, even though I would think... It would be the same thing, right? 2, 3, 4, 5. Hmm. Okay. Interesting. I didn't really expect this to randomize, but okay. Fair enough. So let's head over here and check out this little quest here. So I'm just going to grab some of these more rare items and try and ignore the grass, even though it's really hard for me. Hello, pretty. Oh, I like the creatures in this game. They're so cute. Here we go. Okay, hi birdie. 498, 499, 2500 coins. That's all of them. I'll remove this fence and you can explore the wilds in search of new herbs and items. Oh, and we got explosive potion blueprint. That might be something that would be handy to have if we go into the dungeon. Here we go. Just to have a little overview of how much room I have left. Cool, let's make sure to save. There we go. And yeah, now we can get the blue caladium. We did need some of those for a quest, or for at least one potion. I think maybe two. At least one of them needed 10 of these. So it's probably a good idea. We're gonna go and check out the dungeon in a second. Okay, so there's an area here we can unlock with 3,000. You can imagine how grindy it's gonna get. Especially in the beginning, as you progress, it's probably going to get a lot easier when you have access to many more items and craftables. There's going to be food recipes as well. So there's like all kinds of monster food you can make and things like that. But yeah, we're going to have to look at all these areas. Wow, all of them costing 3,000. Ooh, that is going to get expensive. Hmm. Okay, let's grab this last one. Then we have 9. Well, they should respawn fairly soon, so then we can get at least one more so we can make one of those potions that require these. So let's see. The dungeon has been blocked off for your own safety, Adventurers Guild. Hmm. Well, let's go back and see if that triggered a quest potentially so that we can start working towards unlocking that. Okay, I don't see any more blue caladium just yet. If you guys see some stuff is respawning. Okay, well, we're gonna come back and see if we can get the last one we need. Oh, I see a quest in the distance. So let's head back over here. And... Just grabbing a lid here and there. You want to adventure down the dungeon. Are you sure? There are monsters down there and we can't guarantee your safety. We can open the dungeon up for a fee, but we'll not be held responsible if anything happens to you. Okay, so we need 250 coins for that. Okay, I want to see. Nope, still no new quests here. What was it we needed? Well, we needed more water and stuff, right? to make another one of those expensive potions. There we go. Got some more bottles and I got some water and stuff. Well, I wonder how long this bubble is gonna last. It lasts a long time, or a lot longer than the confetti, that's for sure. Okay, so we need some money, but we did get an explosion. It must be this one, explosion potion. Yeah, so we need some pink caladium, blue caladium. Okay, I'm gonna try and make this, but there was another one. Over here, where we needed blue caladium as well, but I don't really have enough. So let's just start with this one, because I want to see it. So, explosion potion. Let's try and make one of those. There we go. Now we have an explosive potion. Awesome. And I could actually make one of these. Let's see what else. Yeah, we need 10 there. We're gonna need 10 here. And we need 10 there. And then, of course, I have to go back and get more pumpkin slices. I kind of wanted to try and drink one of these, even though I don't think it does anything, but I kind of wanted to try just to test things out, because they said that some potions will have an effect both when you drink it and when you throw it, right? So I want to try and drink that, and I want to test this out, and then of course we need to sell something as well. So we don't need any of this for anything else, do we? Well, we do need water there, but by the time we get to that, we can get some water. I still need to get this, right? So let's make one of these. That should give us a nice amount of money. Right, and we can sell you. And let's head out here. So let's try and drink it this time, just to see what happens. Oh! Okay, so it just does exactly the same thing as if you throw it. I still get Moonglow flowers, but the grass does disappear after a while. You can see it's not here anymore. Okay, well, cool. Then we have this one, which I think we want to keep until we are in the dungeon. Though we're probably going to need more potions than what we have, right? Oh man, I need some storage. But for right now, let's go down here, and then we're gonna sell this bubble potion. There we go, that's 702. Yeah, nice, now we have 900. You know what, let's go over here. Let's just sell this grass. I'm gonna keep a stack, because then we can always do some crafting with it. And everything else I kind of want to keep for now, because I don't really know exactly how much we need and how hard it is to get. Well, these seems to be okay if you go in the earth zone, right? But yeah, you guys know me, I don't really feel like selling a whole bunch of stuff unless I really 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 have to, because then I just have to run around and grind them later. Then I would rather grind some of this easy stuff and sell that, even though it probably doesn't give as much money. So let's head over here to Riley again. Alright, I'll send someone to open up the dungeon for you. Be careful down there. Ooh, we opened the dungeon. Okay, so I'm kind of just wondering how often this is gonna get reset, but I guess we'll see. Let's try and head back over here. Oh, I can't wait until we can tame some of these creatures, but it's gonna take a little while, unless I just go completely crazy with grinding and then leveling up our earth levels. But I feel like we should just do it like naturally. I do kind of wish that you could see it, no, without having to go to the book and see your levels. It would be kind of nice if you could just see it, because I haven't noticed anywhere where it shows you that you actually get that XP or how much XP you get whenever you craft something. There we go, now we can get more of these. So let's just do a quick round and just grab these ones, because then we have other potions we can unlock. Oh, come on, if we can get enough of them. And let's grab you, grab this one, and nope, there's nothing here. So ooh, this one here as well. Ooh, now we have 13. Nice. Okay, well, I guess we're gonna try and go in here and see how it goes. You know what? We are just gonna save. Just in case, because I don't know if there's a bug and it might... Okay, let's go away from that so I don't throw the potion by pressing E. Are you sure you want to enter the dungeon? Yes. Just in case it crashes or something. I don't want to lose what I have just been doing. Ooh. Oh, okay. There's a whole bunch of errors. Okay, well, let's have a little look-see. We do have a skeleton over there. Couple of skeletons. Oh boy. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Okay, well, we're just gonna try and run around a little bit. And then we're probably gonna try and exit again. Okay, so their aggro range is not too big, but right off the bat there's nothing in here. Other than the skeletons. Okay, that's a little surprising because... Oh, no, 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 no. There was actually... Okay, this is probably where you would go to the next level at some point. Because in the original, like, Kickstarter version, there was actually resources that you could collect in here, if I remember correctly. At least there were some plants and stuff. So... Oh. Okay, well, I think we're just gonna... Yep, I wanna exit. So there's not, doesn't seem to be much to do in here other than maybe we can bring a whole bunch of potions and try and kill the skeletons. Here we go. Okay, well, at least we are outside. And... Ooh. Seems like there's a little rendering issue here. None of the plants are here. Oh, here we go. Now they're back. There we go. Okay. So let's head over here. We're just going to grab some more of these. And some more of these. How many do I have of these ones? We have 19. There we go. Now we have 20. That's a nice number. Would fit perfectly for the oceans though. I might as well grab some more when I'm passing right by them. Right. Here we go. And then I think... Now we have been in the dungeon. I wonder if that triggered... Any new quests? Ooh, texture rank tangle out of something something. Yep, early access means bugs. Okay, I don't see any new quests. What did he say when it comes to unlocking a new zone? Okay, we have 65. Does that mean we only get 5 points every time we make one of those? Wow, we have to make a lot of grow potions if we only get 5 points every time. That seems very little. What is that? That's 20 plus... What is that? 35. So it's like 27 or something we have to do if we want to level up to 200. Whoa. And next level reward, yeah. So, how do we get in here? I probably need to get another quest. I don't remember. Did he say how we could unlock that area? I'm sure we need to do a quest for it, or we need to level up, but I don't know which potion would be relevant for that. There might be one of the potions we can make that would be relevant for getting water XP, because we probably have to level up to level 1, right? That's what we kind of did with the earth zone. So let's see if we can make some potions that we haven't done yet. And then see if they give us access. I do have some potion bottles here. Oh, here we go. Okay, let's grab one more and then we're gonna go in here and see what we can make now. Here we go. So we can make this one. Something, something, cooked potato. I don't know if that's what it would say, but that would work. No, it wouldn't quite work. Quite. No, it says potion in the back. Stone cold potato, maybe. Or potion. Now I've got potato on my mind. A firefly potion. That would be kind of cool. And something potion, but then we need water. Okay, so we should have enough to make both of these, right? Yes. So let's try and make this one first. See what it is. Ooh, a smoke cloud potion. Aha! And then we are gonna try and make the firefly one. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the firefly, but I don't see any like XP or anything popping up anywhere. Maybe I'm just blind. I was hoping you could see what kind of XP you get. Instead of having to remember, for instance, that the green or the grow flower one gives you earth XP, right? Okay, so now we have this one, which we can drink. That would, of course, help us. Well, I think you can both throw and drink this one. But it would probably give you some cover when you're in a dungeon. Or you can throw it on some enemies and then maybe they can't see you if you're outside the cloud, I suspect. And then there's a firefly potion. But this one, it doesn't seem like we can drink. Nope, it's not fully available in the game yet. Okay, then maybe we want to just sell it. Let's see. Yeah, 410, so technically we could sell it, right? 15.5. Okay, we might just want to... Well, I kind of want to level this up, right? So maybe we should just make all the ones we can of this one. Oh, right, it's because I'm on this one. That's kind of the issue by them using E for so many things, because you will most likely have potions covering all these slots here, and then you have to press E to actually throw them, right? But you also need to use E to craft and to enter the dungeon and all that stuff. So I would kind of say it would probably be a good idea if you had a different key for crafting, for instance. Okay, so now we have three of these that we can sell. And, well, we might as well sell this since it's not usable. This one should work. Well, I guess, let's see how it works. Let's see how it looks, right? So we're gonna try and drink it. Ooh. Okay. Oh, no, it does follow me. Haha. Yep, at least if I drink it. It might work differently if we throw it, right? But I think this gives us some cover from the enemies. And then we can go down here. And I think we're just going to sell all this stuff. Make ourselves some more money. There we go, 1557. And I don't see any new quests yet. So maybe we just want to make enough money that we can unlock some new areas, at least we can unlock some of those extra areas either in the earth area or over there by the dungeon. There was a whole bunch. We need 3,000, but I kind of want to go and check out and see how many levels we have now. Just to see if something else got leveled up outside of the earth zone. But let's just have a little peek. Yeah, no, this is level 0, level 0, level 0. Okay, we're up to 80 now. We have 65 before, so that makes sense. That's 3 times, and we make 3 earth potions. Oh, seriously, man, that is so many we have to make for those grow plant potions, right? Okay, well, I think that is it for today, guys. I think I'm gonna try and do some grinding, make a whole bunch of potions, make some money, and the next time we're gonna try and unlock some areas. But I'll probably try and wait until we get another round of bug fixes before I make another video. But yeah, anyway, let me know exactly what you guys think about it and what your own experiences are if you are already playing. Maybe you found some other colors of mice or something, or other colors of these other little creatures that are floating around that I don't know what to call. So yeah, that is it for today, guys. Thank you for watching. And as always, do take care and happy gaming.